This is our series, Map Briefings, where we're going to give you the information you need before going into battle. Today, we're going to look at Dunkirk. Hey, I'm Matt Abbott, lead artist for multiplayer at Sledgehammer Games.
And I'm Gabriel Galaz, multiplayer level designer at Sledgehammer Games, and I worked on the maps for DLC 2, The War Machine.
For this map, we wanted to show the story of Operation Dynamo, also known as the Miracle of Dunkirk.
When people think of Dunkirk, there's a very specific image that comes to mind.
On the beach side, we have the evacuation taking place. On the residential side, we have the German war machine encroaching their stranglehold on this beach.
This map is really unique because it doesn't follow our traditional design. It's got two very distinct methods of gameplay. So this line I'm drawing here divides the map basically by playstyle. If you are entering this map and you like to play with SMGs, shotguns, that close range kind of stuff, then you definitely want to stick in this apartment buildings over on this side of the map. But if you prefer more long range, mid range options, then you want to stick to the beach and the boardwalk sections of the level. The boat is a very strong position in this map. It gives you a lot of vantage points to look at. You can control a large portion of the map from it. So any enemies trying to approach you, you have visibility over them. If you get some beddies and set them up at the back of the boat or around the boat, areas where you think players are gonna mantle off of it, that's terrible for them, right. Not for you.
If you look at the ground, how it intersects the boat here, you can see that it dips down. So a character may be about this tall, right? When I come up to here, all of a sudden, I'm just looking over the top. If I'm crouched, got my gun, I'm basically just exposing the tip of my head and I can see anyone trying to come down here. Or go prone.
It's really easy to control large sections of the map from specific areas. If you're a sniper, definitely recommend hanging out in these bay windows.
This is the only way to access that bay window that overlooks the beach. If you picture these stairs going behind this wall up there, what I'll do is I'll put a bouncing Betty right here. So someone running up, it'll trigger and I'll have another one. So I still have one more alert in case someone else is coming up after that guy. What it does is it buys me time at that bay window. I just think it's such a power position. I want to hold it as long as I can.
We really wanted to capture the essence of what this evacuation was like, not only from a gameplay perspective, but from a historical perspective. So we think we did a really good job of marrying those two elements together. We had a lot of fun making this map, and we can't wait to see you on the beaches of Dunkirk.